So I just put a nice kind of textured color on the other side. And they went in this morning and added a grid on top for me so that I can paint it in with the grid. But this paint needs to be in layers anyway. So a lot of it's just about getting a base layer up there while we figure out what we're going to put.
Allison's work is very realistic. Colors are vibrant. The detail that she's working with on such a large scale is amazing, and I think it's brought a lot of attention to the downtown area.
My name is Sherry Simmons, and I'm a city councilor for the city of North Plains. I believe I came up with the idea at one of our city council meetings. We were thinking of things that we'd like to use the URA for and ways to beautify our town. Well, as you can see, they're rather large canvases that encompass a lot of our older downtown area. And so we thought that they would be a great place to start with mural projects.
My name is Blake Boyles. I'm the city manager for North Plains. Well, after the Urban Renewal Agency decided that it was a project that they wanted to use, we got a mural committee established. The group consisted of Sherry Simmons, council member, myself, the city manager, Mr. and Mrs. Dan Van Dyke, who are the owners of the building, Melvin Van Domlin, who is our local historian, Cindy Hirsch, a past mayor, and Heather Labonte, who is also a member of our planning commission, and Stuart King, another member of our planning commission. My involvement in the project was actually helping to put together the RFP, request for proposals, that's what that stands for. There were approximately 20 artists. We whittled it down to four finalists, and then the four finalists, we all had draw the exact same photograph to reproduce. And Allison's work seemed to be the most realistic and most colorful, lifelike, and hands down, she was the chosen.
My name is Allison McClay, and I am the North Plains mural artist. Well, the city of North Plains had a pretty good idea of what they wanted to begin with. And they had a collection of old photographs, and really the majority of the ideas already. So I just took what they had and kind of made paintings and sketches and photo collages out of everything. I've always loved painting. I have a degree in illustration, and so I'm always looking for ways to make a living doing it. And I apprenticed with a muralist a few years ago and just kind of fell in love with it. So I work with grids. It's just very simple. You kind of lay out to scale the artwork and just lay a grid over it, decide how big that's going to be. My grid was 2 feet by 2 feet, so I had a picture to scale about that size, and then we went with a chalk line and levels and rulers and just gridded everything out 2 feet by 2 feet squares all the way up and across, and then just numbered and lettered them. It's just easier, it's just breaking it down so that you can kind of visualize where things are supposed to go. Because when you're translating an image, it's a very small image to something so large, it's easy to get lost. Like I kept thinking, no, this can't be as big as it's actually going to be. And then you look at the paper, oh yes, this actually is 8 feet wide. Once the sizing and everything is sketched in, it's easier to just kind of do the rest by feel or sight, you know. So there's a lot of stepping back and assessing and then going back in and changing things. This is the biggest project I've ever attempted. I've done murals that are the size of one of these walls, or you know, a little bit bigger than one, but six at once has been a challenge, and also the corrugation on the steel is incredibly challenging. It was quite a process. I had to kind of do a lot of research on how to prime galvanized steel so the paint would stay. I was doing a lot of research and finding out that the reason or the treatment for galvanized steel will make, if you just paint straight on top of it, it will slowly just kind of melt off. So I was really worried about, you know, painting a beautiful mural and then having it slowly just kind of melt off over the years. Well, it's going well for the most part. I think it's hard to do some of the more tedious line work, like the train tracks, for instance. Take a long time because of all the ribbing, and you have to get really straight, even lines. So you can spend all day working on a very small section and not see a lot of progress, which is frustrating. Also, on that side, we don't have the ability to use the scaffolding like we do on the rest of them. So it's a lot of moving ladders every few feet, you know, and they're all in the bushes. So there's a row of bushes there, and we've got to move the ladder, kind of stick it in the bushes, figure out how to get around it, climb up, bring all your paint up with you, do a little bit, and then do it all over again. So that gets exhausting. So taking a break from that, we'll go back to it when we're feeling stronger.
Allison has actually gone above my expectations. The colors are very vibrant. Some of the details that she's working on, I never expected it to look like that, especially on a corrugated building. We've been getting feedback already as the project's been going along, and everything is very positive. It's also a almost like a three-dimensional history book. A lot of people have been asking about the buildings, why the train is there, the electric train compared to the steam engine. North Plains was actually established as the town of Glencoe, which was actually located about a mile away from here. To the northeast of here, actually. About that time, the railroad came through and missed the town completely. So they moved the town to be a little closer to the tracks. And then they called it North Plains, actually. And that was about 1910. The photos that you see, or the murals that you see on the buildings, actually depict different times and buildings that were at that period. The electric car actually came through first, and then the steam engine came through, which also helped produce the lumber industry in this town.
Extension ladder day. I have to stay up high all day because James is here to help me move it, and he might not be here tomorrow, so I have to use the ladder today. It's everybody's favorite ladder, this thing. It's such a pain in the butt. But we're almost done with this side, and all the other sides we can use the scaffolding. This one just has bushes, so we're very excited to be finishing up this side. It's just everything takes longer and is slower with the ladders.
I enjoy the role that I have fallen into, where I'm doing the rough outlines and basic structure of things and a little bit of color, because then I'm a little bit little ADD. I like to see progress fast. Allison likes perfection. I like to, you know, like slap a bunch of paint on and step back and go, wow, it looks like I actually painted something. That's cool.
So it will stay like this. The paints that we're using are meant for exterior painting. You know, I went through and made sure all the pigments have a high light fastness. But we will also put a top coat on just to be safe, just for graffiti and UV protection, things like that.
know, I don't think we could thank Mr. and Mrs. Van Dyke enough for the use of their building and allowing us to help beautify the downtown area and still make the building a useful structure in town. It is something that we're thinking of. It could possibly be an annual project. It's picking a building, doing the mural each year.
I think it'll be a good feedback. People are really excited about it, and they come out and they talk to the artist, Allison, and they love seeing. A lot of people will come out and say, oh, I remember that building. I was here, played as a child in front of that building. And it's pretty positive so far. And we're hoping that it'll bring others into the community as well. I just think it's really going to be a positive thing for our city. And hopefully it'll be a start to having other murals done in town.
The North Plains Urban Renewal Agency was created in 2006. An urban renewal agency is designed to encourage economic growth in a specific area. This mural will draw residents and visitors to downtown North Plains, where they can visit shops and grab a bite to eat. The URA is funded through a method called tax increment financing. What that means is the URA takes on debt to complete projects such as this mural, which then help increase property values in the area. When the property taxes increase due to the increased assessed value, that additional property tax revenue goes to the URA to repay the debt.